athlete, and Sandy Cohen's been getting a lot of attention for his skills on the basketball court, Doug.
Yep, the Seymour senior-to-be. We all knew he had a lot of talent the last couple of years watching him play on the basketball court, but now this offseason, he's getting a lot of national attention. Marquette's already offered him. Auburn's offered him. Kentucky's even contacted him.
Things went crazy this spring. You know, I started getting a lot of publicity, and I got my name out there in the UIBL circuit. You know, it just, my name just exploded. You know, it's kind of good knowing that all my hard work that I've been doing finally paid off. This is awesome. You know, this is always my dream since I could remember. I always wanted to go big Division I, you know, and my dream was to go to the NBA. So that's always been my dream. So hopefully I can keep working at that goal, and maybe I can make my dreams come reality.
My name is Sandy Cohen. I'm 23, and I'm from Seymour, Wisconsin, and this is my story.
Basketball has honestly just been like my first love. I've always loved basketball and just sports in general. I used to go to this place called the Rec Center. It was like a 5-minute walk from my house. I used to go there every day after school, and I really fell in love with the game there. There was this guy who used to work there. His name was Jed Summers. He kind of first got me started out with basketball. We used to play all the time. We used to play horse, and you know, that's where I really, really fell in love with the game.
My name is Jed Summers. I'm the assistant director for the recreation department here in Oneida, Wisconsin. I've been working here about 15 years now, 15 plus years. I've been started at one facility out on our Cliff Webster building out on County H, and then I moved over here to the Civic Center.
Can you talk about the first time Sandy came in and how you met him?
Sure. I worked as an intern that summer, and then I came on as a full-time employee right after the summer. And that Cliff Webster building was my first area. And the kids would get dropped off from school on the bus. And that first day I worked, he came in off the bus from Seymour Elementary, I believe. I think he was about 10 years old. Came in, and I think I was shooting around in the gym. I worked in the Learning Center at the time, but you know, at the beginning, we'd all be in the gym. I was just shooting hoops and, you know, just getting to meet the kids and stuff, and saw that he liked basketball, and we started talking and shooting around together, and that's kind of where it started. And then from there on, he came in almost every day after school. We'd be playing basketball together. Right away he'd come in, challenge me to horse or hustle or one-on-one, something like that. We'd play for a little bit, then I'd send him into Learning Center to get his homework done, so he kept up with that stuff, and then he'd come back in and we'd play some more ball together.
You know, Jed was a mentor to a lot of kids. I feel like they're, you know, he was just a good father figure kind of person to look up to. He was just a real good guy. He just made everything fun and better, and just made me always want to go there every day. You know, he kind of got me into baseball. He used to play baseball, so I remember him just like helping me out, like with, like I used to be a catcher, and he was a catcher too. So he kind of used to help me out with stuff like that, and I don't know, he's just like a great guy, just a great all-around guy. He kind of made living in that area like a lot better. And you know, I'm really grateful for the Rec Center and all the stuff that they, you know, they do for kids and the stuff that they did for me.
Well, honestly, he didn't have a great shot at first. He was athletic, tall, skinny, but he could move. And we'd play horse, and I beat him every time because he couldn't make a jump shot, so I just make free throws and that was it. But he was athletic and pretty tall for his age, and then he worked at it every day. You know, he'd come in and play me and challenge me every day. He never gave up, and soon he started getting better and better and better, and you know, he beat me a few times, and then once he got to high school, that was it for me. It was his time after that. So
yeah, John Murphy, he's the high school basketball coach at Seymour, and he's been for, I don't know, it feels like forever. But yeah, he, my mom actually ended up moving to Green Bay. This was like after my freshman year, so I was probably more than likely gonna end up transferring to Green Bay Southwest. And at that time, it was kind of, I wasn't necessarily like a bad kid, but like I really wasn't, you know, I was just like, it just wasn't a stable house. It wasn't a stable home. You know, it was kind of rough. Yeah, almost. I wasn't. Everyone, I had good friends. I was always, you know, people knew who I was. I wasn't like doing a lot of bad things, but like I was probably, you know, super close to like one slip up away from like, you know, not being where I'm at today. So it's just, yeah, they just kind of gave me like a stable home more than anything, you know, just a, you know, I got to school on time every day, you know, someone to help me out with my homework, just little things like that. And you know, the family is just amazing. You know, they're kids, they feel like my brothers and sisters. Like, I'm super close with them, and you know, to this day I'm close with them, and they really feel like a second family to me. And all the things that they have done for me throughout the years, I don't know if I could ever repay them for the things that they've done, because they put me on a path to success, and without them, I honestly know I wouldn't be standing here today. So I'm forever grateful.
That was a great experience for him. Just watching a little knucklehead grow to kind of mature and find a love for something. You know what I mean? A lot of little boys find a love for a sport or several different sports, and you could just tell he found a love for that. I believe I coached him for baseball mainly, but after that last season, I think he was 13 years old, I believe he stopped playing baseball and focused on basketball, which is, as you can see now, was a great idea for him. And you could just tell that he had a passion for it and a love for it, and it was great to see him put all of his energy and all of his time and to work at it at such a young age. And he, along with his gift of his being lengthy and being able to jump out of the gym and put it all together, find a shot, and just work on it to be a complete basketball player, was great. In high school, we followed him as much as we could. I believe his junior and senior year, we would gather up as many teenagers and kids, load up the 15-passenger van, and we would follow him from game to game and watch him play. And it was great. It excited those kids. It got those kids motivated. Watching him do what he does on the court, they would come back thinking they could be like Sandy. So it was great motivation for them, and it was great motivation for me to just watch, you know, this young kid that I've known for so many years, you know, doing his thing on the court and what he loves to do. And I mean, I love watching him play even now.
I love the Marquette. I love the people I met there. The coaching staff was great. My teammates were great. It just wasn't a good situation for me. I feel like I kind of fell into like a mental rut there, and I couldn't get out of it. It had nothing to do with the coaches. It didn't have anything to do with the playing style. It was just me personally. I got into a mental mind frame that I couldn't get out of, and I felt like I was stuck there, and I was stuck in a role that I couldn't get out of. And I knew if I wanted to play at the next level, I had to go somewhere else where I could be more of a focal point and, you know, do the things on the court that I wanted to do to play at the next level. And in my mind, it was now or never. I have half of this season, which this season I haven't been playing at all. So more than likely, I'm gonna waste my whole junior year on the bench, and then I'm only gonna have one more year at Marquette, and who knows what's gonna happen that next year. So I was like, I need to go somewhere where I can make things happen. I need people to see my skill. I have a lot of potential. And I, even though I wasn't always playing the best and I was still in that mental rut, I still had faith in myself. I knew I could play at a high level, and I just knew what type of player I was, and I knew how high my potential was. I knew how high my ceiling was, and I knew the things that I could do. And I just needed to go somewhere where I knew the coaches believed in me and were gonna let me do what I needed to do. And here at Green Bay, I'm grateful for them because they let me do those things and they had 100% faith in me. I guess it's probably just like naturally instilled in me, you know. I don't have to think about it. It just kind of comes naturally, just like, you know, just trying to, you know, being raised in like my dad not being around much when I was younger, just me, my mom, and my sister. Then my brother came in a little bit later. He's a lot younger than us. It's just, you know, just going through that struggle with them, and you know, it just pushes me and makes me work harder. And at the end of the day, that's my motivation, and that's what just keeps me going. So, you know, I don't know if I play with that chip or it just naturally instilled in me, but yeah. Absolutely, you know, the tournament feel is do or die at the end of the day. So you gotta come with it. You gotta come with it from start to finish. All two seasons over pretty much. So it was amazing to get the opportunity to be playing in that tournament.
No, he's a great kid. He matured a lot moving up here and coming back to Green Bay. I think it's great for the family to have be able to watch him play. He's doing a lot of good things for our community in Oneida as well as the Green Bay community. So we're super proud of him and excited to watch him play and continue on, hopefully professionally. He carries a lot of our community in Oneida. He carries them on his shoulders. He does a good job representing our people. And
You know, one of the reasons we've had our success this year is because of how well he's played. I think he's really played well here down the stretch of the year for us, and you know, he's been a great person to be around, been a great teammate to the guys, has worked extremely hard to get to where he has, and he's got a very bright future when he's done with playing here at Green Bay as far as having a professional career for a long time.
How they do it, and then you know, here at Green Bay, they really just let me play. You know, I played through. I made mistakes on the court, and they wouldn't yank me out right away. You know, they just let me play as a player, and they let me develop. They didn't let me develop by practicing. They let me develop by playing, putting me in different positions. It's an amazing feeling when you have a coach that truly believes in you, and he doesn't do it by his words, he does it by his actions. The game come to me. I'm the type of player that likes to make the right play, whether that's me shooting it or me passing it or me just trying to go get as many rebounds as I can. You know, I'm not the type of player that's gonna take 1,000 shots a game and force it one-on-one every time. You know, I like to get my teammates involved, and I like to play the right way. So a lot of people kind of knock on me and say I'm not aggressive enough and I don't have that dog mentality, but at the end of the day, I just try to play the right way and make the right plays. And if that's me shooting it, if that's me going on one-on-one, then that's what I'm going to do. But if it's me making a play for another player, then that's what I'm going to do if I feel like that's the right play.
Incredible to me to see a kid from, you know, the trailer park on the reservation, and he didn't let that stop him. That stops a lot of people, you know, but he worked hard, did what he needed to do off the court and on the court to be successful.
Physical game and probably a tough game to ref. I mean, because you got two teams that like to get up and down. They really got up and pressured, which we hadn't seen a lot of that here in the last couple games. You know, they mixed up their defenses and did a good job. That's what we want. I mean, we wanted the ball in his hands. We ran a little single screen where he loops around. The good thing is they switched. So I thought they did a really good job of guarding him, the little guards getting up and really pressuring. They switched. And then we had PJ coming out the backside and Cam coming to the middle. And you know, we got it to Sandy, and I'm glad he went and, you know, shot the shot. That's the guy you want shooting. You know, I mean, Cleveland State, that's who we wanted shooting him tonight. At the end, that's who you want shooting.
Yeah, of course. This was actually a play that we drew up. We went to this play plenty of times in practice before, so it wasn't anything new for us. We already kind of knew the play, but Yeah, I just came off a double, came around, just looped around and got the ball. Surprisingly, I thought I was going to get doubled, or I thought they were going to try to get the ball out of my hands. But no, it was just a pretty much one-on-one, so I got to bring it up, and then I got right to my favorite shot, one dribble pull-up, and then... As soon as it left my hands, I knew it was cash. That's a shot that I worked on all summer. It's a shot that my coach has preached to me to get better at and elevate and jump higher. And it's just something that I worked on, and I knew it was good when it left my hands. So that's one of those, I don't really know the word I'm looking for right now, but just one of those moments where it's like you dream about pretty much. You know, hitting a buzzer beater like that in a game like that and at home, in front of my friends, my family, my last home game. It's like one of those things you look back on and you just kind of get like chills thinking about it. I feel like, not just for me, but for my teammates as a whole, I feel like a lot of people grew up in that tournament and found themselves and found their game. And I just hope they can carry that into next year and play with that same mentality and that same spirit and that same fight, because if they do that, they could have a special season next year.
And, you know, I'll say something about Sandy here is it's amazing, and I don't know how, if he's the quickest guy in Green Bay history to 1,000 points, you know, but not only that, when the season's done and you go look at single season rebounds, single season assists, single season free throws, single season field goals made, different things. He's going to be up at the top of all those. I mean, he's had an unbelievable, you know, senior year and single season. I mean, some guys get in points, some guys may get in assists. He's getting it in every category. He's got a chance to be in the top 10 in everyone, and I think in points he's second. He's going to be close to second all time. And assists, he keeps moving up. I mean, that's an amazing accomplishment in that. In 1 year, he's been able to do all that. You know, I mean, there are not many guys that can put their name in a record book in 7-8 different categories like he's going to be able to.
Would he have gone down as one of the greatest of all time here if he had played all four seasons?
I mean, he may go down in a year and a half as one of the greatest of all time. You know, I mean, what he's done and accomplished. I mean, you know, in my short time here, he is.
Yeah.
Where's your mindset?
My end goal is obviously I want to play in the NBA. That's been my dream since I can remember. So I'm definitely trying to make that a reality. And I don't see why I can't make that happen. I feel like I have all the tools to make that a reality. But, you know, this first year, I'm just trying to, like you said, I'm just trying to get in where I fit in. And, you know, wherever that's at, I'm just trying to play at the highest level that I can play at, whether that's in the NBA, the G League, or overseas. I don't really care. I'm just trying to just play at the highest level that I can play at and develop my game. I'm still young. I'm only 23, and I feel like my ceiling is very high. So I'm just trying to just keep working, keep grinding, and I feel like at the end of the day, I feel like my talent can take me to the NBA.
Don't edit none of this either. Don't edit none of this. Don't edit none of this.
Like we always do at this time, keep the cold blowing your mind. Hey dummy, this no accident, all of this was designed. Took my time, kick a crack from behind, and I opened up your blinds, rise and shine. Cold world, same nigga used to drive around with your girl in my mama's Civic, now I'm out here trying to get it. I ain't like you lame ass.
And after two anxious days, the former Green Bay Phoenix standout accepted an invitation to play on the Cleveland Cavaliers summer league team.
I ain't got a gimmick, I just flow. The niggas went nuts for the boy that set fire to the booth. In a game full of liars, it turns out that I'm the truth.
Come on, baby girl.
Proud. It's great to see him as a person now, you know, a young kid who's kind of finding his way and overcame a lot as a young kid to being a rookie pro player this year. off the floor, I've seen him grow so much as a human being, you know, making better choices in life, and how much he does for his community, the people around him, his family, his friends. He relates to so many people, you know, whether it's little kids to old guys coming up and wanting to get an autograph or a picture, he's always willing to do that, and just seeing him continue to grow as a human being.
I'm proud of you. If you would have told me back when you first came to the rec center that you were going to be a professional athlete, I would have probably giggled a little bit and shot a three in your face. But I saw the work you put in. This wasn't given to you. You worked hard. You did what you needed to do, and you made it. You know, don't let anyone tell you different.
Just keep doing your thing, big guy. Keep your head up. Keep working. Just keep working. Don't give up. Don't give up. We're all rooting for you, man.
Stay the same person, but continue to strive for whatever dreams he has out there. He works hard, puts in the time that I know he's going to put in, and keeps hitting the weights. I think he's going to have a long pro career, and he can't let all those things change who he is at heart, which is a good person.
The only advice I feel like I could really truly give to anybody is just you got to believe it and you got to work for it. If you have those two things, it's possible. But if you don't put in the work and if you don't believe it's going to happen, then it probably won't. So, you know, you just got to keep that confidence and, you know, you got to work every day and you got to be consistent. And with those two things, I think almost anything is possible. Sun gon' shine, rain won't stop, oh no.
If I should die before I wake, pray to the Lord, my soul to take, my soul to take, my soul to take.